15-year coaching career is renowned across the country for her recruiting prowess as well as on-court success, bringing over great players at Northern Illinois, University of Maryland, and Illinois. So I'd like to give her a hand and welcome Coach Marsha Frese. And last but not least, Danielle Bratton. Danielle is our newest coach. Last year, she was the director of basketball operations at Northern Illinois. She has had the misfortune of being with me way too long. I recruited her as a 17-year-old student-athlete, played under me at Illinois and at Ball State. And if any of you have ever wondered what it looks like to be stared down by Pat Summitt, she was a member of the Ball State team, a starter on that team, actually, that knocked off Tennessee in the first round of the NCAA tournament a couple years ago. So she brings a great knowledge, great playing experience, just a great young coach, and our graduate assistant, Liz Sowers, up top. So gals and guys from Columbia College are going to appreciate the action today because we're not going full court. So get a little rest here this morning. You know, as Dan mentioned, you know, I started my coaching career working with my sister, Brenda, who's the head coach at the University of Maryland. And, you know, her success, she was really fast-tracked early. At one point, we were in three schools in 4 years. And it was just go, go, go. And the thing that working with my sister taught me early was just adaptability. We played every system, every style you can think of. You know, worked alongside Bruce Weber, who's now at Kansas State, Gary Williams at the University of Maryland. We've learned every system you can think of. And we've really worked to adapt to whatever personnel we had when we first got to the school until we were able to recruit the student athletes that we looked for the style of play we wanted to play. But one thing that always stayed consistent no matter where we went was that, you know, whether it's guys or girls, you know, our girls did a really poor job of moving without the basketball. You know, we kind of have a running joke. Two guys walk into the gym, one ball, and they say, hey, you want to play one-on-one? They get after it and play one-on-one. Two girls walk into the gym, and you hand them a ball, and they go, you want to rebound for me? And it's just the differences between girls and boys playing basketball. You know, guys always want to get the ball back in their hands. So they really move and work to get their action. You know, last night even watching the Minnesota Lynx, Lindsey Whalen, the Olympian point guard that I had an opportunity to coach in Minnesota. You know, great player with the ball. The minute she'd get rid of the ball, she would do her best statue impersonation of any kid I ever saw. We'd show her on film, she'd get rid of the ball, and she'd never move an inch after that. So we've really worked no matter what system we have in place for the players we have of teaching our team how to move without the ball. And these are things that can be adapted at every high school level. One thing that was important for me today was, you know, if I come in and show you our motion, come in and show you our matchup defense, you know, are you going to be able to adapt that for practice 2 weeks from now? Well, we're going to show you here this morning drills and things that you can put in right how complicated you want to get with them. So we're going to get started just with a wing and a post player. Okay, wing and a post player. We're going to show you how we build our system a little bit. And there's no fancy name for this. We literally call it guard post slides because we don't know what else to call it. We impress upon the team, this is not a play. This is just a series of actions that we use whenever one thing happens, something else happens. Little bit different with guys, but with girls, we tell our kids all they can do is bounce passes in the post. They're not allowed to do any overhead passes. We do this for a couple reasons. The first being that when our bigs work really, really hard for position, we don't want them to then have to come off the paint, lose their position, just to go get a bad pass by one of our guards. The other reason for that, obviously, is that anytime you have high side defense, the majority of your turnovers are coming in that passing lane. Okay, so we just have a rule from day one. Everything's bounce pass to the post. We're 4 days into practice now. Our kids, when they throw an overhead pass, the entire team just drops down now without us even saying a word. They just go ahead and do their push-ups for missed passes. So, you know, and I'm not crazy. In a game, our 6'3 center is probably going to get an overhead pass, but at least if we drill it in practice, in a game, we'll get more bounce passes than we ever did. So our first rule of thumb is anytime we pass in the post, we're going to bounce pass, we're automatically sliding. So let's just get a line here. Bounce pass, automatically sliding, kicking out to the wing. The minute you kick out to the wing, our bigs immediately take a piece of the paint, repost, get ready for the shot and the repost. Okay, so let's just get a line, get some balls going. And we just call this in and outs. We're not real fancy about the names we have. Go ahead. Just bounce pass to the post, slide, get position, shot. That's all it is, in and outs. Get in position, shot. We're gonna show you how we build this. Slide, get in the paint, shot. Good. Bounce pass, slide, get in the paint, shot. Slide, get in the paint, shot. Good. Slide, get in the paint, good. You can go ahead too, get that repost. Go ahead and repost, hit the post. Kick out, repost to the post. Good. Good. Go ahead, call this in and out. So when we start practice, we just have two groups going in and out. So we'll say that side's getting shots, that side's hitting the repost. We'll just get the action going. Now, when I worked at Ball State, Tim Buckley was the head coach there. Tim Buckley had a little more advanced system where he would dictate which way they slide based on which way the guards or their defense are turning. Okay, so if their defense was forced to middle, they would always slide to the high leg. If their defense was facing baseline, they would always slide top to the high leg. Okay, so you can adapt it to your system. We just try to keep it as simple as possible. Let's bring a guard up top. You can find that. Okay, as we start to build it, our guards are on a string. Our guards are on a string. So anytime they pass into the post and slide to the corner, they're pulling the other guard with them. Okay, so we always have two outlets, a corner and a top. Okay, and we just tell our top kid, just be in the sight line of the post player. So if he starts to turn, do some type of up and under or a hook shot, you're turning with him. Okay, we tell them, just pretend like your big is like your gun, the shooting gun, and you're following the arm of it. Okay, so you got to get into that. So, slide it back up, and go ahead, bounce pass, slide, kick out, shot. Two options. Okay, here we go. Same thing, let's go. Bounce pass, slide, kick out, shot. Okay, we got multiple options. One more time. You can hit that repost too. Slide, pass, repost, shot. Good. Okay. Okay. Let's add a third guard. Yeah. 1, 2, 3. And real basic. You can start the ball on top. Okay. So I mean, it's not rocket science. Pass, bounce pass, slide. We tell our weak side guard that they got to be in line for the outlet on the weak side. Okay. So if he got doubled. Okay, if he got doubled, he may have those options right there. If he buries somebody in the paint, he knows. Good. Okay. Let's take the wings off for a second. Let's take the wings off. Let's go ahead and get somebody at the trail post. Actually, go ahead and do that. Come here, you trail stop. Okay. So we showed you just a little bit. That's just stationary. We'll get a little further into it in a second. Okay. Just like our guards work together, our bigs also work together. So for every action, there's a reaction. Okay. So anytime our ball gets passed into the post, we're telling our opposite big to dive. This is not, you know, complicated stuff at all. Okay? But we're telling that opposite big to dive, and the immediate look is that obviously he doesn't have a score, he's just looking to drop it off. Just drop it off. Okay? So we obviously, as you just saw, we have a wing on the back side. You can go ahead and put this back side as well. Okay, you're in the trail spot. Let's go ahead and feed the post dive. Dive, slide. Good. Same thing, here we go. Feed the post, dive, slide. Good. And we'll do breakdowns just like that, where we just feed the bigs, dive. Feed the bigs, dive. Feed the bigs. Talk a lot about just talking and communication. We always have one high, one low. So let's go and do it from here. Bounce pass, slide, dive, slide. Okay, yeah, either one, shot. Okay, here we go. Bounce pass, slide, dive, shot. Good. Good. One more time. Bounce pass, slide, dive, shot. Good. Okay, if we had a third guard, Coach Doyle, maybe if you want to step up here. Okay, remember if we had a third guard here, okay, pass gets made. Bounce pass, slide, dive. Okay, you can see we have three outlets. One, two, weak side, dive. Okay, you got three outlets. And that's why sometimes, I know Coach Buckley, when he wanted to get a little more complicated with it, okay, on occasion, he would tell his guys to do this. Bounce pass, and instead of sliding, he would dive the guard through and slide home. Okay, so you can add more movement to it, however you want to make it work. For the lower levels, keeping it simple is an easy way to do it. For the higher level, higher intelligent, you know, get them cut through and go ahead and fill in. You can also bounce pass in. You can sometimes come set a screen for the other guard and fill in. Okay, so you can add to it and be as high amount as you want with it. Okay? Let's get it. Okay, what happens when we start adding dribble penetration? Okay, so just give me a line of the post and the wing. Okay, post and wing. Okay, obviously they're not just going to stand there all the time. Sometimes they're actually going to dribble. Okay? Okay, our rule of thumb, again, not rocket science. We look to attack the elbow. Our big steps out to the short corner. Okay, so that's all we do. Attack and kick. Here we go. Attack, kick, shot. When we always work our guards, active rebounding on the weak side, get them in. Go ahead. Drive, kick, get opposite, hands up, rebound. We never let any of our kids rebound. This circle's been good for us. We tell them the only rebound they're getting right here is a made basket. So we treat them like linemen. They need to always have their hands up, driving back. You know, our goal is to get people out of the paint. Then they can go get the basketball. Okay, so don't let them rebound under the rim. Drive, kick, opposite rebound shot, good. Here we go, drive, kick, opposite rebound shot, good. Drive, kick, and obviously then we add to it with our bigs, okay? Bigs when you step out, okay? So the shot, rip through, go to the rim, rip through, go under the rim. Go ahead. Under the rim, good. Good, here we go. Good. Good, very good. Okay, so let's put a guard up here and our trail post. And our trail post, you're fine. We'll sit up this. Go ahead. Okay, because as we start to add pieces and parts then, okay, how do people work together? Stay up here, please. Okay, good. Okay, ball's here. Okay, ball's here. You're on the ball. Okay, ball gets here. We're attacking. Okay, remember the rule. Go ahead and attack. No, drill penetration. Go ahead, stop, okay? Our wings are on a push and pull, as we just showed you. Okay, so as they attack, she's coming at her, she's sliding that way, other big is dropping down. Okay, so at any time, she's got four options. Shot, And Coach Gratton did a good job stepping out as that third guard. You can see, you know, when you add the third one in there, they're all just moving on the street together. A lot of options, good. Okay, bring it back. Okay, you guys hold stagnant for a second. Let's change to the drive. Okay, this time it's dribble penetration to the baseline. Okay, to the baseline. So she's attacking. Her first look is looking at the rim. Obviously, our first option is always to score. Okay, if his defense steps up, we're immediately pitching for the shot. Okay, so let's just do baseline drive. You guys hang tight for a second. And it's probably just going to be like a shuffle pass or just an outside hand, really flip it up the lane to him. Good. Shot, good. Here we go. Attack. Up the lane. Shot. One more time. Attack. Up the lane. Shot. Good. Okay. And very basic, but you watch a lot of games and you see kids from the printer attacking the paint and they're like, the bigs never move. And then we're on top of each other, we have no space, we have no outlets. So they've learned they gotta move, okay? So the same reaction happens. If she starts to dribble attack, stop there, okay? Our rule obviously is one post high, one post low. So as he starts to circle head up the lane a little bit, our other big would drop. Okay, our guard, because she's on a string, is sprinting behind to the outlet. Okay, sprinting behind to the outlet. So if you get into the short corner here and you find you've got nothing, your last case scenario is you kick behind, shot, and you're just outletting to the other side because here comes that opposite guard going to the top. So we help our transition defense because the nature of our slides pulls another guard to the top automatically. Okay, so as soon as she attacks, she's pulling. Okay, she's back for transition defense. This shot, you'll get a ton. This shot, you'll get a ton. It's an awkward jump stop sometimes and kick behind, but they're not defending that. And I can tell you, if this is a bad pass, the shot that will also be wide open is the double kick. Okay, this will be wide open then. Especially for us, I mean, we've got a lot of catch and shoot kids, so anytime we move the ball quickly, we're going to get them a good look. So let's start up here, just working in tandem, Coach Grant, if you want to slide in too. Attack, slide, kick, line option, good. Everyone in position to rebound, trail guard, guard back to transition. Dribble, slide, good, kick, score, good. Take that one too first. Attack, slide, good, kick, good. And you can see it just becomes second nature. Keep going, guys. It just becomes second nature for them, where they're pulling each other, they know where to drag each other. You get to the point with your team where if they don't have those outlets, they get tipped. Because they're like, stop, and they're getting ready to throw it. And I'm like, where are you at? You're supposed to be behind me. So they start forcing each other to shot. And see, you make that block. Slide. Good. Good. Okay, let's add one more slide. Okay, one more slide. And this is something, guys, you can just stay put for a second. This is a slide that has changed over the years based on just personnel and what's worked best. Okay? Anytime you make this pass to the wing, okay? And we start to penetrate baseline, okay? She's pulling, okay? We've adapted it for our personnel, but we've used this as a baseline grip, okay? Because kids really seem to like to, you know, they get out of control too, and guys sometimes, I know you guys like to come in and do those one-handed pitches. So we've dropped it where the baseline is going to drift, okay? So drive baseline, drift, you're still behind her as the release. As soon as you make that pass, Good. Up the gut. Good. Shot. Good. You go either direction with it. Attack. Drop. Good. Up the gut. Good. Okay. So let's add the guys to it. Okay. So it's the same slide as you saw. Go ahead. Drive. Slide. Short corner. Shot. Okay. You want to tell your big on that weak side. Okay. He's just kind of in a short corner type position, ready to rebound. Usually that guard will get under and pitch well before they get there anyway. Okay, so you just don't want to be in the line of fire. Here we go.
These are some high ones where they were.
Good. Back. Good. One more time. Good. Pitch. Good. Good. And like I said, we've adapted this over the years because, you know, if you need to simplify it to the point where you tell your wings, no, it's just all push and pull, push and pull, then when you make that drive, just drag all three of them to the top. Then there's no confusion. Then they just push and pull, push and pull. Okay, you don't have any of that confusion. But for our purposes, that drift has been really good for us. We have a lot of kids who can make that shot. You know, we just drill it a lot and they get that pretty easily. Okay, top down drives. Okay, start with the ball on the top. So go ahead and the paint. Kind of come on up here. Come on up here. Just make a line underneath. Okay, what happens if we penetrate from the top spot? Okay, the natural tendency as you start to come down the lane is that this big always likes to step short corner. Okay, we don't want him short corner. We want him on the opposite block. Okay, for that very reason, when the defense steps up, okay, this kid is wide open. Okay, because help side defense, when the ball's up here, is in this position, they got to be able to get down now on top of our big. Okay, so ball's up top. We just look, our girls, I think we're calling it rail runners or whatever. We just attack the big, slide across, pitch. Good. Next two, here we go. Attack the big, slide across, pitch. First option obviously is to score, so they always need to be looking at the rim. Score, good. Good, score. Last one, here we go. Good, score. Okay, so bring that wing back. And piece it together, okay? So, I mean, usually when we do this in practice, we'll start it in, you know, where we're not stagnant. So we'll start with the ball, then we'll kick it back, okay? Attack the rim. You're sliding with her. Shot, okay? So remember, because our guards are on a string, okay? Our guards are on a string. So anytime we attack, go ahead, ball here. Attack, you're sliding with her. Kick, good, okay? So now they have two options, okay? They come down, if they don't have that shot, okay, most of the time, this kid's defender always has to make a choice. When she starts to attack, she's either gonna go here, which leaves this kid wide open, or she's gonna stick. Okay, if she sticks, that's fine, then we're on one-on-one coverage, then we've got the layup, okay? But if she helps, we're always gonna have this. What I see a lot of schools doing, it's just a preference thing, is that they'll do the pitch behind. Yeah, I don't really care for the pitch behind that much just because it's hard footwork for some of them to come off and we haven't created any space. Okay, so Coach Grant, if you want to get up top, add the third guard with it too. Okay, go ahead and start it, attack, penetrate, slide, pitch, and get out. Good. So as soon as you get rid of it, so you can pitch, you can pitch here or there. Here we go. As soon as you get rid of it, follow your momentum and get out, okay? So if she doesn't shoot it right away, just follow your momentum and get out. You've got this other guard sliding up on top. Get out. Good. Okay. Attack. Pitch. Good. Get out. Good. Okay, let's add our other big. Okay, and this time, remember the rule. So if he's sliding across, if he's sliding across, then we really don't want it too low. We just need this other big man to kind of get in the gap, get ready if there's a rebound if you're going after the ball. Instead of, let's hit the pitch, but then we hit the double kick. We're going to hit the double kick, and then both our bigs are in position.
Yeah, but it is cool because you see that.
Okay. Good job. So we talked a lot about double kicks. I'm looking for our double kicks. We talked a lot already. We talked a lot already to our team about good shots and bad shots. Good shots have nothing to do with whether you're open or not. It has everything to do with whether your feet are ready, your hands are ready, whether it's a shot you can make. And double kicks in particular, we tell that kid in the corner, if your hands and feet aren't ready, shot fake. If you still don't have a shot, kick it. Because usually that second pass is going to be wide open. Go ahead. Good. One more time. Good. Okay, so you've seen a ton of the options. You've seen a ton of the options, okay? I want to just show you some of the breakdown drills then that go with it. So let's put a three line, a two line, and then big's you're good where you're at. So just go ahead and fill where she's at. Okay, we start our practices with this stuff every other day. Just gets a lot of shots up, gets a movement, and we can do any option. So as I started on the top, we start with in and outs where we just bounce, pass, slide. Bounce, pass, slide, and we'll say one side shots, one side hit the repost, and then we'll switch, okay? Then our next option is here. So all we're working on is bounce, pass, dive. So go ahead, bounce, pass, dive it in, and then we'll start working on this shot here, okay? Pass out, post, get in position to rebound, shot. Okay, so let's do that option a few times. Slide, dive, shot. Bigs get in position to rebound. And you can make this as physical as you want. You get guys in there with pads. You go after our bigs, they have to rebound. Go ahead. So we work on a lot of things at one time, getting in position to rebound, rebound, put back, go up and score.
Didn't speak too kindly of them.
Should be calling for the dive. Go ahead.
Also, didn't speak too kindly of them from
okay, Coach Merritt, we're taking it to the next step, okay? And as I showed you, then we start getting into two lines again. We'll just start working on our dribble penetration series. So we'll have two-man game, pass, dribble, shot, and we'll just do it continuously. Just keep going. Do the same thing. We'll add the baseline, move it up to the top, we'll add the slice, okay? When we start getting into the team stuff, this is where we progress it, okay? So that action, we bounce fast, we dive.
Because this is inside the one.
Sorry. Go ahead. Bounce fast. Dive. Opposite. Okay. We're immediately telling them, okay, you're in a repost situation. Our guards have the rule. You cannot pass to the post unless you're below the free throw line. Because most defenses are going to be high side. Okay. We need to do a better job of passing ankles. And as most of you know, like, passing is such a lost art that if we make rules and they have to follow them, we have better success. Okay, so anytime we get this pass here, we dribble it over to improve our position. The opposite post always pops high, okay, because we never have two bigs low, okay? So we're going to hit opposite, drag it down, and let's refeed the post first, okay? So we'll refeed the post, dive and slide, okay? So it's the exact same option to flip up. Here we go. Dive, drag it, get high, drag it, dive, okay? Anytime it goes to the post, the other one's diving. Okay, guards are sliding on both sides. Dive, drag it up, dive again, slide. Okay? So you see on the second drag and kick in, you may not get a dive the first time, but as soon as we repost and this big gets high, we'll get the second dive quite a bit. And as soon as that pass gets in, our weak side guard is again the outlet. Slide, dive, repost, dive, slide. One more time. And it just starts to become an action, just habits that they get used to doing. Dive, slide, one get high, dive again, slide. Good job. Obviously, you have a third guard up here as well. You know, who's moving, dragging, sliding, okay? Good. Good. And let's increase the action again. Okay, this time, pass in, dive, opposite, flash high. Okay, good. You slide up. We hit the high post this time. We hit the high post. Obviously, we work on this shot. We work on this shot, catch and shoot, catch and drive, catch and duck in. You got all three options. You're looking at some high low type stuff. Okay? We tell our guards anytime there's a perimeter drive, it doesn't matter if it comes from a big or if it comes from a guard, you treat it like a perimeter play. Okay? So the minute he would attack, you're sliding into the corner, weak side of big is getting positioned, this guard is on a string, you're right there for the outlet. Okay? So our hope is obviously that he gets to the rim, but again, here's this man's defense in the passing lane. As he starts to just drive, you get a lot of this. Very undisciplined. You get a lot of that, and all of a sudden that's open. You know, we've got some really good shooters right now, so I suspect that a lot of defenders are just going to stick on our guards, which is great, because then we're one-on-one coverage to the basket. Okay, so let's get that high post look. From the high post, yeah. Yeah. Attack. Good. If you got any action, you can kick it. Slide with it. Kick. Good. You can shoot it or you can double kick it. You can shoot it or you can double kick it. Good, you got an opposite.
and then when you send it in the magazine.
Same option when you feed the post, sometimes you got it.
It comes out in January, and it's got half a season's worth of, you do a story, and a preview.
Kick, dive, slide, opposite, repost, one get high. One get high. So you're forcing your kids, no, you're forcing your kids when she goes to pizza, you gotta come high. One's always high, one's always low.
You can do an article on something.
You're in the kids.
Nothing to do with stats.
One time, dive, opposite, now solid, dive again, good. Okay, you see it's just continuous movement. Continuous movement. And anytime you end up with both guards on the same side, anytime your bigs cannot settle for just kicking or kicking, anytime your bigs can do this, okay, you're gonna see things really open up. Okay, because this is a quick pass, you'll get that from time to time. But if you can make that pass, obviously if you're the passer, you're following yourself. Okay, you're automatically following yourself. Now you're in a two-man game. Now you're in a two-man game. So, okay, let's say our opposite big flash up. All of a sudden, you guys run an offense where it's a two-man game. Okay? Well, now I'm big again. Now I'm grab the pole again. Okay? So let's get to that. Okay? Let's get to that. Get opposite, two-man game, and then slide from there.
I need to run an offense, I guess.
Screen.
You want some of those pink out places?
Kick. Brian, there you go. Two-man game. Okay, good slide. Good slide. Good slide. Do it again. This time, two-man game to the inside. Two-man game to the inside.
I don't want my password to go back. Base camp stuff.
Dive. Call your pass. Two-man game to the inside. The inside. Come back. Come back. You're okay.
Except
yep.
For
here it goes. Dive, opposite, flash, slide it, good. Good. Okay, when you see the wings, just like that, your big gets out of the way, you penetrate, your big gets out of the way, your guards slide. Now we tell our guards, like, say they kind of got offset, and one of them ended up, like, much lower than they needed to be. If they're getting stagnant, they can always have fast moves. Okay, and fill the space. Okay, so it doesn't have to be, you know, where they're on top of each other. They can move around. Go to something just basic like America's play. So two wings up top, two guards on the wings, or on the block. Okay, like a box set. And again, an office loves this play. Okay, cross screen. Come out of the elevator. You guys go through the screen together. Come up the top. Okay, not there, Phil. Not there, Phil. Phil. You dive to the block. Okay, let's say you came up instead of all street. Right now we're back in slides again. Back in slides again. We ran initial action. Now we're just playing. Now we're just playing. So she's looking to attack. Okay, if she's sliding, if she can't turn the corner, she's got a kick here. One big high, one's low. And you got any outlet you can get. Okay? You make a pass, just follow yourself through. So any play you can think of, any basic set, run your initial action, and then you're just playing. Move with each other, follow your pass through. So once you make that pass, go ahead and cut out. Yep. Just let your momentum take you to the other side. Screen, slide, kick, get out. Good. And we'll set them up so we go through strong hands, coming off ball screen, strong hands, ball screen, slide, good. Get the action to the top and then stop. Should be done too. So we screen, guys split, okay? Let's say we rejected the screen, okay? That kid was cheating, we rejected the screen, all of a sudden she's attacking. Across the lane, okay, he's getting in rebounding position in the paint. You got an outlet to the corner, and you got an outlet behind. More than likely, it's going to be a double kick to get to her, but then you've dragged your guard to the top. She's ready to back in transition defense. Then use it. Attack, 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 kick. Good. Good shot. And Coach Doyle and I were actually just talking about this slide last night. For some reason, kids love to follow the three-point line. It's like their favorite thing to do. For you to make a slide from the weak side all the way to the top, I mean, shortest distance between 2 points is a straight line. You got to get them in the habit of just flashing as hard as they can to here, looking for that shot. It also keeps the defense honest because they got to knock you down as well. Let's try that. So there's a lot of different systems that we can talk about.